Welcome students, families, and friends to our first virtual watch party for the high school award ceremony. Even though we're not able to meet face-to-face, we feel that the students deserve the recognition for their hard work from the school year. Our teachers and staff have put together a ceremony to honor and recognize the accomplishments of these outstanding, high-achieving classes.
We will now present attendance awards. We will first recognize one student who has attained almost perfect attendance. This student has missed no full days of school and only has a few tardy check-in or check-outs. That award goes to
Carter Stivers. Congratulations. Well done, Carter.
First up is a leadership award presented to Faith Axline. The next award is a player to watch. That's Jada Hughes. Our most improved player is presented to Lexi Tillett. And the Warrior Award goes to Camille Scott.
I'd like to recognize the students who attend the Shelby County Area Technology Center, earning their industry certifications and working on career readiness. In automotive, Brendan Hahn, Wyatt Mitchell, Jose Munoz, Sean Wheatholder. In business, Christina Morales, Amber Scales. In health science, Angela Foltz, Mariah Perry, Aiden Quinn, Aubrey Robinson, Alexis Shields, Maddie Simpson. In industrial maintenance, Aaron Hamilton, Braden Murray, and Quentin Rader. In welding, Andrew Clute, C.D. Ethington, Abelardo Reza, and Jonathan Zarcillo. Congratulations on all your hard work during this year.
I would like to take this opportunity to honor our student council representatives for the 9th through the 11th grade. This group has been amazing. They have helped me out with so many things. They have helped make a lot of decisions and a lot of changes for our school to make it even a more amazing place to be. They have represented their classmates well. So for our freshman officers, we would like to recognize Secretary Josh Rozenka, Treasurer Julia Dittinger, Vice President Marissa Weaver, President Cadence Combs. And for our sophomore officers, Secretary Elijah Cook, Treasurer Hunter Gibson, Vice President Gabby Mathis, President Ashton Montgomery. And last, for our junior officers, Secretary Taylor Payton, Treasurer Zeta Owens, Vice President Maya Dalton, and President Brooke Berry. Thank you for your service to your classmates.
And now, our related arts teachers will present their awards for achievement.
Hello, my name is Becky Barnett. I am the foods and nutrition teacher, and I am ready to present my awards. My first award goes to Jorge Rangel. I am giving him a certificate of awesomeness for always doing what needs to be done and extra. Thank you so much, Jorge. You're wonderful. My next award is for Jaden Browning. This award is for her awesome attitude and her excellent effort. She's been such a shining star and was the best student during NTI. Thank you, Jaden. My next student is getting the Character Award. The Character Award is going to Miss Ashton Montgomery for a student that is poised, confident, and always very responsible. Thank you, Ashton. And my next one goes to a student that has much integrity, so much outstanding improvement, and all her extra efforts in class, Tiana Roth, You've come a long way. Thank you. And my last award for high school goes to a young man. He has the top grade in the 9th through 11th grade. He's a very hard worker. And besides all of his work in my class and other classes, he's also a Bellarmine student. And he has the highest grades and he gets the Achievement Award. And that is to Adam Lucchini. Thank you, Adam. Thank you.
Hey, guys. Each school year, starting in August, the yearbook staff makes a pledge to cover as many school events as possible to ensure that all of your accomplishments that school year are credited in the yearbook. I could never put the yearbook together alone, and I want to take the opportunity to thank all of my underclassmen yearbook staff members. Maya Dalton, Aurora S., Jeremiah Hedges, Nikayla Higgins, Rebecca Lynn, Gabby Mathis, Taylor Payton, Jada Redman, Marcella Riza, Audrey Wilkerson, and Clarice Wilkerson. Thank you. I'd also like to take a moment to recognize one particular student who went above and beyond to make the yearbook awesome. If I needed an event photographed, this student was happy to help out even if the photographs were for a page that wasn't her own. She has an incredible talent for photography, but her grit is what really made her a true journalist. From the second she was assigned her pages until the absolute last day before the pages were due, this student took every opportunity to make them better and better, and that is what being a yearbook staff member is all about. At this time, I'd like to present Aurora S. with the Yearbook Staff Member of the Year Award. Congratulations, Aurora. I'd also like to give one final shout out to Jeremiah Hedges for his design of this year's yearbook cover. His creative design won the majority of votes in our class cover competition. Of course, I'd like to keep the design a secret until distribution day, but just know that when you see that awesome cover, you can thank Jeremiah for that. Congrats again, Jeremiah Hedges. Thank you again to all of my yearbook staff members. Stay happy, stay healthy, and always know that I'm here for each and every one of you. Have a great summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, welcome to the Dance and Drama Awards. I mean, I have to be a little dramatic, right? All right, it's time to stop monkeying around and get down to business. First up are our dance awards. The best part about teaching dance is getting to see the transition between the beginning and the end. At the beginning, they're like, oh, I'm too afraid to dance. And at the end, they're like, oh, okay, it's fine. I can totally look stupid in front of people. Let's do it. Hello, you all have TikTok. You dance looking silly every single day. Huh. Why can't you do that every day in my room? I don't know. Okay, I'll quit clowning around. All right, our high school dance academic achievement awards go to Marissa Weaver and Desmond Runyon. And the crowd goes wild. For our choreography award, congratulations, Cadence Combs. And the crowd goes wild. Nice job, you guys. Congratulations.
But soft, what light. Through yonder window breaks. It is the east, and Juliet is the sun.
Wait. No, that's just the sun. Sorry, guys. It's a new day, and that means we're ready for some new awards. So let me find my awards hat real quick. Oh, there it is. Sorry. All right. Woo. Well, as you can see, we're ready for some Theatre Award!
Oh. Hello. Is anyone there?
They invited me and told me I'd be talking to people. I hope there's people listening. Okay, well, without further ado, I'm here to present the Theatre Awards today. So, for academic achievement in high school theatre, congratulations, Taylor Payton and Kyra Harris. And the crowd goes wild. All right, now we have some very special awards today. I'm going to need to remove my glasses, I think, to read these. These are a little tricky. I see. Okay, so for convincingly faking an injury during improv week while mixing up Tanya and Nancy, the Nancy Harden and Tanya Kerrigan Award goes to Kyra Harris. Congratulations. And the crowd goes wild. All right. For their ability to say so much without saying a word, the Godfather Award goes to Ryan Scott and Brock Weaver. And the crowd goes wild. It's clapping, so there must be people here, right? Alright, that's good. And finally, for her lovely British accent, just like Gwyneth Paltrow, and let's see, who else do we have here? Renee Zellweger, yes, that's true, as well as Meryl Streep, yes, all of those lovely ladies, and in all of those movies that they did, yes. You have earned the English Rose Award. Congratulations, Taylor Payton. Thank you to all those who were clapping for me. Even though I don't see you, it was a pleasure to be here today. I feel like someone should tell him that we were clapping for all of you. Anyway, congratulations, everyone. Even Dexter says congratulations. I miss you guys, and I can't wait to see you next year. Love you. Bye.
What's up, Warriors? Welcome to Miss Hill's house during NTI. For media, I wanted to celebrate two students in my class. This was a brand new class this year, and these two underclassmen always consistently went above and beyond every single day to make sure that our class ran really smoothly. So I would like to award the Excellence in Media Award to Elijah Cook and Abby Rozenka. Thanks so much for all the hard work you guys did. Appreciate you.
Hi, Miss Montgomery here. I have two awards that I would like to present for my community-based problem-solving class. The first award goes to a student who was always positive, always looking for creative solutions, and she was always willing to jump in and work hard. So I would like to present this Excellence in Community-Based Problem-Solving Award to Julia Ramos. My second award goes to a student who was very resourceful, diligent, ready to work hard each day, and he always had a bright smile on his face. I would like to present this Excellence in Community-Based Problem-Solving Award to Cameron Higgins. Great work, you guys.
Buenos dias, estudiantes. Yo soy el señor Quist. I am Mr. Quist, and I teach the Spanish 2 classes. Miss Sai takes the others and has done a fabulous job with them, but I have the honor of doing the Spanish 2 classes. So, without further ado, I have a few awards that I would like to present. So, let me switch over to my awards. First up, I would like to award for the Animado in Spanish Award. This first goes to Hunter Gibson, who has done everything that he can to be as excited as possible for everything that we do in class. Now, there's some fun stories that go along with this one, as we have our second, who is Angelis Hernandez. Angel and Hunter are tied for this award for the Spanish 2 second period class because it was because of each other that they earned it. Angelis brings a certain amount of competition that is infectious, and Hunter has a wonderful attitude that was able to play off of that. It has nothing to do with their actual ability in speaking Spanish, because if you listen to Hunter, he can be really interesting sometimes. But it has everything to do with their enthusiasm and how much they try and encourage others to also participate. For the first period class, I also awarded the Animado in Spanish Award to Cole Hannon. for his excellent work. It's always hard doing a first period class, and he was able to step it up and bring some excitement and encourage those around him. It was always fun to see what new combination of words he was going to put together. Muy bien. I am extremely excited for all of these students and very proud of all their efforts in working through this class. Buena suerte a todos.
I'm Brittany Roederer, and I will be presenting the Art Awards.
This Art Award is presented to Violet Scott for Outstanding Achievement in Art. This Art Award is presented to Sabrina Kimes for Outstanding Achievement in Art. This Art Award is presented to Julia Dettinger for Outstanding Achievement in Art. This Art Award is presented to Reagan Wilson for Outstanding Achievement in Art. This Art Award is presented to Lizzie Sorrell for Outstanding Achievement in Art.
Hi guys, I'm Miss Sox, and I'm here to present our PE and Health Awards for this year. First, we're going to start with our Academic Achievement Awards. First up, we have Bladen Malone, getting an Academic Achievement in Physical Education. We also have Matthew Thomas, getting Academic Achievement in Physical Education. And for Health Education, our Academic Achievement Award goes to Grace Ross. And we also have Sarah Welsh, getting her Academic Achievement in Health Education. Next, we have Leadership Awards. Our first Leadership Award in Physical Education goes to Bryce Sipes. Our next Leadership Award in Physical Education goes to Vince Dettinger. Our Sportsmanship Award this year goes to Logan Sisko. Our Just Do It Award, for those who participated even when they didn't feel like doing anything, go to Aiden Hinton and Shelby Spencer. Our last award is our NTI Initiative Award, which goes to a student who excelled in this weird time, and that is Desmond Duncan. Great job this year, guys.
Hola, my name is Catherine Tsai. I'm one of the Spanish teachers at the high school level. I teach Spanish 1 and Spanish 3. I have a few awards today. First, for highest academic achievement in Spanish 1 is Megan Sweeney and Sarah Welch. Congratulations. I also have some special awards for two students who were very talkative this year, but it definitely paid off. They are determined to become fluent in Spanish. And so for that, I present the Most Eloquent Speaker Award to Jack Ruzanka and Cadence Combs. Felicidades. Gracias. Adios.
And now it's time for the Music Awards. Our first award today is for Most Improved Musician. This award goes to a student who's shown significant improvement in the categories of tone, rhythm, articulation, and dynamics. The student has shown true dedication to getting better on their instrument this school year. Congrats to Philip Jameson. Our next music award is the Musicianship Award. This award goes to a student who has shown leadership in the band class. They are a consistent model of good tone, rhythm, articulation, and dynamics. They work not only in class, but in their own practice time to better themselves, which in turn betters our Eminence High School band. Peers look up to this student for their time and dedication that they put into making their instruments sing. This year's Musicianship Awards go to Taylor Lyon and Grace Ross. Congrats.
Good evening. It's an honor to give you an overview of our Eminence Exemplars and the process for those. The Eminence Exemplars have just completed our eighth year of implementation. Eminence Schools has led the nation in terms of ensuring that transferable essential skills were taught hand in hand with our core instruction. We want our graduates to be at the forefront of jobs, careers, and skills to pave the way for a sustainable future. 2020 has been a reminder of the importance of why we've set such a clear vision. Our exemplars are required from every student to advance to the next grade. However, students may independently work to complete as many as they desire. There are 8 attributes to our graduate profile, and each attribute then has 3 standards for every grade. Completing 1 standard from each attribute is required to obtain red level status. 2 from each attribute receives the prestigious white level of attainment, and completing all 24 allows the student a status of blue level. This level represents the highest honor an individual student can earn in a given year, embodying our vision of being well-rounded and world-class. I now present to you each student and their level of attainment.
Blue level exemplar status is for students who have completed the highest achievement of Eminence Exemplars. They have completed all 3 tasks of each component, totaling 24. Those earning blue exemplar status in the 9th grade are Marissa Weaver, Reagan Wilson. In 10th grade, Angeles Hernandez, Ashton Montgomery, Aiden Quinn. In 11th grade, Brooke Berry, Maya Dalton, Nikayla Higgins, Rebecca Lynn, Taylor Payton, Audrey Wilkerson. Congratulations to those students for earning the blue exemplar status. They had to spend a lot of time on their own to complete these exemplar tasks. Congratulations.
And now our content area teachers will present their awards for achievement.
I'm Ms. Buell, and I'll be presenting the Algebra 1 Awards, but before that, I want to let my students know how badly I've missed you guys, not just as a classroom of students I have the privilege to teach math to every day and to laugh with every day, but I miss you guys as individuals and the unique characteristics and personalities that you all have. I've enjoyed our Google Hangouts, except I can't wait to see you guys face-to-face in the fall.
The Algebra 1 Most Diligent Award goes to the student who worked hard every day, who asked questions until they absolutely understood, and who did not stop until the work was done, Julia Dettinger. And for the student who never took the easy way out, even when the going got tough, and proved being determined plus hard work plus perseverance equals a tremendous amount of success, the comeback kid, Philip Jameson. For the student who accepted absolutely nothing less than excellence, the Algebra Academic Achievement Award goes to Sarah Welch.
Hello, sophomore class. This is Mrs. Ciraldi. Academic excellence in biology is awarded to Caleb Shuck. Academic excellence in biology awarded to Madison Simpson. Aquaponics Award given to Jonathan Sarcillo. Academic excellence in integrated science is awarded to Hunter Gibson. Astronomer Award is given to Cameron Hillard. Another Astronomer Award is given to Adam Lucchini. The NTI Science Award is proudly given to Desmond Duncan. And the final award, NTI Science Award, is given to Sean Wietolder. Thank you guys for such a great year. I'll miss you. Congratulations. Hello, junior class. This is Mrs. Ciraldi. I have an Academic Excellence in Forensic Science Award to give to Kyle Deaton. Congratulations, Kyle. Hello, freshman class. This is Mrs. Ciraldi. I have some awards for you today. The NTI Science Award is proudly given to Philip Jameson. An Academic Excellence in Integrated Science Award is given to Bladen Malone. Another Academic Excellence in Integrated Science awarded to Megan Sweeney. Thank you, guys.
So welcome again to Miss Hill's house during NTI. This award is for academic achievement in my English 3 class. I would like to award it to my friend Julia Ramos. Thanks so much for your hard work, Julia. Appreciate you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mrs. Lanham, and I am presenting my awards for World History. I have 2 awards today that go to students who have worked hard all year to maintain their grades, to ask questions when they don't understand, and have also worked hard to be great examples to others and to be a strong leader in the classroom. So my first Academic Achievement in World History Award goes to Sarah Welch. Congratulations, Sarah. And the next award goes to Philip Jameson. Congratulations, Philip. Hi, everyone. I am Mrs. Lanham, and I am presenting my awards for Integrated Social Studies. The first awards I have are for 2 students who have always done their best. They've always tried hard to make up their grades and to stay high achieving. They are also students who have been great examples in the classroom and have been a leader to others. So my first Academic Achievement Award goes to Ashton Montgomery. Congratulations, Ashton. My next award goes to Elijah Cook. Congratulations, Eli. The next award I have is my Citizenship Award. This is something I give every year to students who have worked hard to develop their understanding of government and politics and what it means to be a contributing member to society. They've also worked hard at being a good example and a strong leader to others in the class, especially when we've tackled some tough conversations. So my first Citizenship Award goes to Angelise Hernandez. Congratulations, Angel. And the next Citizenship Award goes to John Van Landingham. Congratulations, John. And congratulations to all my sophomores. It's been an incredible 3 years, and I'm so proud of all of you.
Hey, my friends. It's very interesting that we're doing awards this way this year. But for my 9th grade English class, I have 2 awards to present, and they are right here in my hand. I want to talk about each student for just a moment, because I believe this is being aired and that parents are going to see this, and this is just super important for you to know. In the middle of this year, this English class has gone through 1 lead teacher who moved to another position, and then I came in as lead teacher, and then we ended the year with COVID-19 and the quarantine. So this award really shows, both of these awards show a lot of perseverance and just stick-to-itiveness in a time that it's been difficult to try to learn. So I'm very proud of both of these individuals. The first individual that I would like to give the highest GPA in my 9th grade English class, this award will go to Philip Jameson. So Philip had the highest GPA in my class. Philip is the model student as far as doing what I ask him to do, turning everything in, and always, always trying. So mom and dad, be very proud of your son. I know I am. Secondly, our next award goes to the most improved student in my English class. And this student, I kind of had to crunch some data and some things like that and really look at grades and what the student has put into it, where they started and where they ended. So even though the student doesn't have the highest GPA award, this student has made the most growth in my class over a year's time, which is super important when it comes to trying to continue to grow yourself. So I'm very, very proud to give this award to Miss Delisha Jackson. So these will go out in the mail to you guys, and everybody else in my class, keep working because everybody in my class is awesome. Talk to you guys later.
Hi, I'm Eunice Metcalf, and I'm presenting awards for our class. Mr. Jackson, I would like to congratulate Patrick Maloney on receiving an award for most significantly improved reading. He's been working really hard this year, and we're real proud of him.
And we would also like to congratulate Tabby, if you'd like to tell us about that.
Okay. Tabby Combs is going to receive the Library Service Award. She's been doing a great job at the Henry County Library. The next award goes to Corey Forte. He gets the award for service with a smile. He tries to always have a positive attitude. He's great at serving people.
Perfect. Hi, Warriors. Mrs. Stacy here to present English awards. Congratulations to everyone.
The first award for English 1 is given to Sarah Welch for highest academic achievement. The second award is given to Julia Dentinger for intellectual pursuits. The next award is given to Reagan Wilson for scholarship, creativity, and leadership. And the final award is given to Elizabeth Sorrell for ingenuity and originality. The first award for English 2 goes to Ashley Ortega for academic achievement. The next award goes to Elijah Cook for academic achievement. And the final award goes to Hunter Gibson for dedication to learning. The first award for English 3 goes to Brooke Berry for innovation and scholarship. The second award goes to Isabella Bates for creativity and scholarship.
My name is Kelsey Knott, and I'll be presenting the English 2 Achievement Awards for my class. Congratulations to Aurora Estes for academic achievement in English 2. Congratulations to Angela Fultz for academic achievement in English 2.
Hello, I am Mr. Scrivener, and I will be giving the Science Awards for physics, for an outstanding performance in physics. The award goes to Brooke Berry. The Newton Apple Award for perseverance in physics, for being thrown into the deep end in a pool full of sharks and swimming her way out. The award goes to Audrey Wilkerson. I will be giving the awards for geometry and pre-calculus. For outstanding performance in geometry, the award goes to Cadence Combs. The Euclid Straight Edge Award for perseverance in geometry, for being able to complete all her work and record a TikTok video every class. The award goes to Madison Simpson. For outstanding performance in pre-calculus, the award goes to Brooke Berry.
This year's U.S. History Award goes to someone who worked very hard in class and who was awesome to his fellow students. And this year's U.S. History Award goes to Cole Hannon. Congratulations.
Hey everyone, I'm Mrs. Shipp, and I have two awards that I want to give out for integrated science. I want to give out an academic achievement award to Grace Ross. And I'm also going to give out a Future Engineer Award, and that's going to Trey Gunther. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ms. White. I teach Algebra 2 and College Algebra, and I have a couple of awards to give out. So for Algebra 2, I have three awards for academic achievement. The first award goes to Camille Scott. The second award goes to Angelis Hernandez. And the third award goes to Maya Dalton. Congratulations, ladies. Thanks for being awesome. I also want to give out a couple of College Algebra awards. College Algebra, we had a great group of underclassmen this year in College Algebra. We've had two rock stars that have really been giving it their all, 100% effort all the time. And so I would like to give my two College Algebra awards to Chloe Stivers and Rebecca Lynn.
We'd like to thank all of you for viewing our first ever virtual watch party for the Eminence Awards program. Our goal at Eminence Independent is to grow our students academically, socially, and emotionally. We truly hope that you will take full advantage of the many opportunities to learn, lead, and grow into responsible citizens for the remaining years in your schooling career. Have a great day, Warriors!